We're living in extraordinary times. The president's legal team did a presentation in front of the media, essentially their opening argument. So like the opening argument you would see in an actual trial. They're pushing for a trial, and they're claiming that there was targeted fraud and targeted misconduct. Basically, there were people in Democratic cities who were outright violating the rules. They were accepting votes beyond 8 o'clock at night on election night. They were violating the law. There were instances where the Dominion software and voting machines were compromised. They were basically programmed to rig elections. They were making some serious accusations right now, serious accusations. The team included Rudy Giuliani, the president's attorney, Sidney Powell, and among others. But those are the two main people who were speaking. And if they can prove this in court, if they could prove that there was over 600,000 votes counted in Pennsylvania when it shouldn't have been, we're gonna live through. You think 2020 has been crazy so far? We're gonna see something extraordinary, and I hope no matter what happens, if there's a situation where the media isn't happy with the outcome, and there's riots, and there's gonna be riots unlike anything I think we've seen in a very long time. It's gonna be really bad. And I hope you guys, if you're living in cities, I hope you're prepared. I hope you're taking some measures for sure. In Michigan, there's some there's some craziness going on in Michigan as far as the vote in Wayne County. First, they had two Republicans and two Democrats on this, the officials, trying to certify the Wayne County election results. Well, first, the two Republicans said, no, we're not going to certify it. Then they changed their mind late at the last minute and say, okay, we will certify. And now they're saying, oh, well, we're going to rescind our certification. And as a result of Trump's lawyers, they're pretty much pulling back their lawsuit. They dropped their lawsuit because they wanted to stop the certification process. Probably because I think they want to take a closer look at what happened in Wayne County. Wisconsin, I think there's going to be some type of recount. There's a recount going on in Georgia. I don't know if that's over yet. But the issue is, if you're going to have a recount in Georgia, you got to be able to verify whether the votes were legal or not, because it seems like they're doing it. They're counting the mail-in votes without looking at the signatures, without having the verification of the signatures, and it seems kind of ridiculous to count illegal votes over again in a recount. But these are extraordinary times. No matter what happens, I hope you guys are at least prepared to hunker down in your apartment or wherever you're at in the city for 2 weeks. You never know what's going to happen. You got to be able to have enough water and food to ride out whatever is going to be coming ahead. And I hope you guys have thought about that. I've been talking about Thanksgiving a lot. Thanksgiving, I'll probably be working on Thanksgiving, but you know, to me, most holidays are just another day for me. There's no point in me going back to Michigan. I don't want to risk bringing the COVID-19 or coronavirus to my mother. She's kind of up there in the years. And it's kind of sad because I don't think I'm going to be able to see my family ever again, really, with this coronavirus situation. And it's just unfortunate. I don't want to show up in my Darth Vader looking mask either. But I'm not going to get to see friends or family in Michigan. It's 2020. I saw a meme on Facebook showing a big tidal wave, a big wave of 20. It said 2020, and right behind it was an even bigger wave. It said 2021. I hope that's not true, because 2020 is it's been a challenging year for a lot of people. I just wish, if we're gonna have elections, I think they should really count for. I think they should be honest. Although at this point, like I said, I don't have much faith in the system at this point, no matter what the outcome is. Obviously, there's a lot of questionable things that happen on election night. Giuliani was saying that basically the reason why the system crashed, the reason why they stopped counting the votes is because the programming wasn't really set up to prepare to deal with a scenario where Trump was getting so many votes. That's why you saw Trump ahead in Michigan and Wisconsin and all these Pennsylvania and all these states on election night and later into the morning, or early into the morning, but then everything ceased, and then, you know, the next day, everything went the totally opposite way, which is really fascinating, because typically, you know, the cities, they usually get in a lot sooner than a lot of these rural areas. You expect the rural areas, the more Trump areas, to come in a little bit later on, but anyway. Main thing is that please be prepared. Please get your vehicles prepared, get your homes prepared, get your families prepared for whatever may happen. I hope you guys put some thought into it. Obviously, you want to cover all your bases with water and protection and food and all this stuff, but please, please, don't just sit around and just wait on it. If you're on the fence, go ahead and do it. Go ahead and get prepared, just in case. Even if you're just prepared for just 2 weeks of just being in your home. There's talk of more lockdowns, more lockdowns. What's interesting about the lockdowns is that if they were so effective the first time, why are we talking about, why are we in this situation? And what's really interesting is that the death rates aren't soaring. They're not going up. You know, they're not soaring, especially when you compare to the earlier part of this year. They're not soaring. So why is there such an urgency to, oh my goodness, we got to lock it down again. And the mask, don't get me started on that. I see so many people not even wearing the mask correctly. And frankly, most of these masks aren't even rated to filter out a certain amount of particles. So what's the point, really? I mean, I wonder how effective they are. I wonder if they are really effective in reducing the amount of virus that people get and therefore gives people a better chance of surviving. And maybe that's why the death rate is down. I don't know. But really, I think people need to be wearing a P100 if they're really serious. P100 filters out 99.9%, more than that, of particles in which the virus will probably be in. So you gotta wonder, what's the bigger agenda here? Because I don't view it as, oh, we're gonna protect the people. Then you have these politicians who are advocating lockdowns and all these social distancing measures being caught violating their own measures. Like the governor of California, Newsom, there's a photo of him with like 10 or 11 other people in a dinner or something. Like, what the heck? I mean, so what's the real agenda here? And then there's the vaccines. They're being pumped up as, oh, this is going to be the next great thing. This is going to be the end. This is how we get over this. Anyway, guys, share your thoughts. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. I'm not getting that vaccine.